Coronel, General Levet seek you.
Wel?
Wat zullen ze het hier keer noemen, veldkornet? Dapperheid?
Dit was Gerry, generaal. Iemand moest hem helpen.
Natuurlijk. Nou, hier is een dringende opdracht voor je president. Wat ik je nou ga vragen, neef, moet je beschouwen als een verzoek. En niet een bevel, niet. Dat is natuurlijk vrijwillig. Je kan later besluiten. Ik zoek iemand om een zelfmoordcommando te leiden.
Ik vecht voor mijn land, generaal.
Dank u. Onze agenten in die Kaberg hebben de Engelsen een groot offensief gepland om ons tot oorgave te doen. Jij moet de 100 mannen bij ons commando's uitzoeken en ongemerkt achter die vijandse linies deurdringen tot in die omgeving van Port Elizabeth. Waar jullie zoveel mogelijk ontwrichting moet veroorzaken en jullie bezighouden tot ons generaals ons verstrooide krachten weer bij elkaar kunnen krijgen. Onthou, jullie zal net een 100 man wees omringd door een groot machtige vijand. Net het paar zal terugkomen. Misschien niemand niet. Die mannen wat je kiest zal dit duidelijk moeten verstaan. Jullie succes zal ons mensen die moed geven wat hulle nou zo nodig heeft. Tot ziens, Chris. En probeer alles in je vermogen om hulle plannen achter te komen.
De Engelsen zal binnenkort versterking sturen. En dat zal dingen baie moeilijker voor ons maken. Vandaag ontmoeten ons die vijand voor de eerste keer. Mannen, ik wil jullie net weer herinneren. Schiet alleenlijk op bevel. Is dat duidelijk?
Ja, veldkornet!
Gaan zo een beetje voor hem toe. Krijg een beetje voor hem toe. Man, wat voelt u hier zo? Hier, Mira. Nou, kom. Zet doodstel, of die zet door je gang.
Zie je die schaduwis onder die bomen daar? Net nu zie je jullie niet meer zien, maar hij zal nog daar is. Verstaan je?
Ja, mazer, ik zie mazer.
Net een woord van jullie de volgende 2 mijl is klaar, praat
Ja, ja, mazer.
Hoor je?
Wie is die rooimier besmette vent? Hé, wat is een lange story. Vraag je om haar zelf.
Hey, vol water.
Nou is alles voorbij.
Nou begin alles weer.
Hoor je? Hoe het jy hier beland?
Waar? Hier?
Ja, hier.
Oh, wel, ik het geen om mijn munitie af te laten.
Man, nou op met bondspring.
Wel, ik is per ongeluk hier.
Je weet, je lijkt voor mij al te veel naar het dorpsjapie.
Ja, zien ons. Als twee van de mervis in die commando, toen kies je liever keer hier.
En wie zijn schuld zal het nou wezen als je hier tussen die klapkopjes doodgeschiet wordt?
Wel, ik weet niet. Zeker die handen van de mervis.
What the hell's going on down there? Shut up! Shut up! Shut up, Pastor! Shut up! Shut up! Pastor, shut up! You there! What's this all about?
Mazza, some 20 men take everything from the wagons, there by the stream.
What the devil are you talking about? The tarpaulin's still over the carts.
Mazza, there's nothing there. They got revolvers, so I don't argue.
Some of you there, loosen these tarpaulins. On the double! Jump to it!
What the blue blazes?
Corporal! Corporal! Escort these wagons to the outspan. Sergeant, my horse! Follow me with your troops.
Mysterious, Sergeant. No trace of them, and we've come to a dead end.
They must have left the stream a bit farther back, sir.
Quite possible. Get your men to search every inch of ground around this pool first.
Yes, sir.
Dear Jock, I don't like this. They tell us those boars are like hairy apes in the zoo. Dig it up in them trees.
What, with 10 flipping tons of ammunition? No Fleming likely. At least I hope not.
Excuse me, sir. We found this note pinned to one of the empty wagons.
We were 10 yards away from you and could have killed every one of you. Signed, the Cavaliers. The Cavaliers? Who the devil are they?
Ons zal hier moeten blijven een paar dagen. Die Engelsen zal morgen zoals een gewonde tier wees. Daar is een hele paar honderd van hulle.
Als hierdie plan werk, Chris, zal die mannen voor eeuwig bankvast achter jou staan. Zie je daar die ammunitiewaans daar links? Ons zal net moet wachten tot het goed donker is.
Sergeant, make a few men and burn the grass ahead of the fire. We'll Sir. Cover you. Try to get around the fire.
Fall back! Fall back!
Get away from those ammunition wagons! Fall back!
Chasing around like a lot of blooming sheep.
We don't stand a chance, sir.
Back.
Fall back!
Freddy Rex on sea of fear. One says he drops a cavalier. Hurrah, hurrah, on Slavy Kaki's waltz. Hurrah, hurrah, on Ray of the Lazan. On Sonders of the Maker, good in England, good the town. Don't tell the holy point is lifted. Hurrah, hurrah, the cavalry is a scorn. It has, on spec, so long she goes not on. On spec, for what on status, reckoning wrecks on sea of fear.
Kalkies het jou geskiet. Ek er honderde.
O nee, ek skiet hulle. Hy draal hulle weg, 200 elke arm.
Is seker een oor elke skouer ook nog.
As julle my nie hierdie keer saamneem nie, loop ek self na die boer toe.
Asseblief, Boetie Sarel, praat met hom, hy is jonk.
Ek kan goed skiet, oom. Kom luister jy nie, Boetie.
Moet jy nie bekommer, Louise. Ek sal hom oppas.
Hy is jou verantwoordelikheid, hoor.
Sal jy ook 'n oog oor hom hou, Ben?
Maar ek het mos gesê ek sal hom oppas. En nou?
Daar kom die Engelse.
Gaan gou die perde.
Wie is nou bang vir 'n paar kakies?
Wat is Louise?
Wat zei, wat wil hij?
We've heard reports about a commando called the Cavaliers.
I know nothing about them.
You know the penalty for helping the boys?
Hoekom sê jy nie vir hom hy moet loop nie?
Where's your father? Fighting for the Boers, I suppose?
Was. My mother and father were both killed in action.
I'm sorry.
Sê jy vir hom, wat praat jy so baie?
One of your farmhands said your grandfather sold us some cattle.
I'm sorry, I lied to you. There were two men dressed in black. They didn't give any particulars. They paid for the cattle they took. They could have taken them without paying. We couldn't stop them.
Tell him that we want all the livestock that he can sell. If he cooperates, there won't be any trouble.
Ons wag maar liever hier, Oosien.
Hands up, Tommies! Drop your rifles, and I mean it!
Ooh, lost.
How long do you think it takes to get back, Corporal?
Take at least a day to get back to the column. Môre, Chris.
Môre, Chris.
Môre.
Môre.
Boetie? Jy weet seker dat jy nie hier kan bly nie.
Oom?
Ja?
Kan ek met jou praat, oom? Man tot man?
Ja, praat maar.
Het oom nie dalk 'n lywig nodig nie, oom?
Ek is seker jou oupa hulle het een baie meer nodig op die plaas.
My suster kan hulle oppas, oom. Sy skiet al amper net so goed soos ek. Buitendien, oom, ons man se plek is hier in die veld. Ons moet die werk eers skoonmaak van die Engelse.
Nou maar goed, ou seun. Gaan kry maar vir jou klere.
Dankie, oom.
Ons is die trotse kavalier. Hoera, hoera, die kavalier is ons. En dan, ons weg, dan langs die grondland vol.
Ek neem 'n paar manne saam met my om die treinspoor op te help. Die res van julle kan môre vroeg by ons aansluit voor dagbreek.
Ons sal wees voor die aankryveld kon het.
Toe, wys vir ons die teken.
Ek? Hoekom ek?
Ja, ons wag vir jou.
Reg, manne! Gereed! Vuur!
Hallo, is dat Lord Kitchener? Luister, ou kat.
Probeer weer Engels.
Listen, kid, old chap, your telephone service is a frightful mess, you know. Ja.
Maar oom, hoekom is dus nie by die ander nie?
Wel, jy sien, daar is genoeg van.
Gaan ons dan nie skiet nie, oom?
Ja, ja, later as dit nodig is.
Maar, oom...
Hey, there's a fire on the track. It looks like an ambush. Let's go through. But the line might be smashed at that point. I'm not staying here while this ammunition blows up.
Come on,
get
man!
Out! Cover! It's an ambush! Oh. Get out!
Out, everybody, out! At the double!
Only a little boy.
You! Saddle! Calm down, calm down!
Ek is jammer.
Wat het jou besiel, man? Besef jy dit beteken krijgsraad? What are you going to do about it?
You'll be court-martialed. Don't worry. Ben, hierdie man is onder arrest. Hy is jou prisonier.
Maar het sal maande duur voor ons hier by die hoofkommando is. Maar is niet zo erg.
Ik is jammer, mijn vriend, maar ik moet alleen wees. Ik moet dink.
Ik geloof niet dat je skiet niet. Niet als je zo faal lijkt niet.
Hands up!
Drop your rifle. Hands up! Move! Move!
Easy car, Grease!
Hands up. Net daaronder, je weet geen daar waar die vierde draai mag. Ik heb de stok geen op die gebeur gevat en daar zullen. Bogus.
Maar dat is dan Mani en Sias.
Jullie hebben amper jullie laatste grapje gemaakt.
Dat is alle manier hoe ons kon weerkomen, Chris, met de brief van die generaal af. Dankie. Maak jullie maar thuis. Dankie.
Welkom, boeren.
Dankie.
Toe, Marwan. Dat is niet zo erg, nee.
En waarover gaan dit alles?
Ik moet dadelijk Kaap toe.
Kaap toe, maar begrijp niet.
Daar is groedingen in die lach. Ik moet iemand van die inlichtingsdienst gaan opzoeken en verdere instructies bij hem krijgen.
En ons?
Jij neemt bevel hoor.
Chris, je weet toch dat ik nooit jouw plek zal kan volstaan.
Ik heb volle vertrouwen in jou.
Baie dankie.
Ronnie, darling. People are watching.
Oh, that's all right. How are you, darling?
Very well.
Good, where's your father?
He's at the castle waiting for us.
Pardon, sir. The general's waiting.
Yes, it's been a long time. We shall have a lot to talk about. Shall I see you later?
If you can escape Daddy before then. He's been in a vile temper these days.
Not about us.
No, dear. Not us. You know he hardly bothers anymore. I think he's given up hope.
Have I? Almost.
Better not keep Daddy waiting.
Look, after the war, I think we should...
No, later.
Magnificent shot, if I may say so, sir. You'll bag the Cavaliers just as easily, sir. This war can't possibly go on very much longer, sir. The Boers are finished, sir, if I may say so.
Really?
Yes, sir.
Twaddle. You said that 6 months ago.
Excuse me, sir. Captain Rogers is here.
Well, don't just stand there. Bring him in.
Sir.
That's all, thank you, gentlemen.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Hello, my boy.
Hello.
How are things shaping in Port Elizabeth?
Pretty well, sir, though we're having our fair share of trouble.
Yes, I hear. Cavaliers, eh?
I'm afraid so, sir.
That's what I want to speak to you about. Care to join me?
Thank you, sir. 100 up, sir.
Yes. Same stakes?
I think so, sir.
They're disrupting our communications, looting our stores and ammunition supplies. A handful of untrained, undisciplined Boer farmers terrorizing half the British Army and making Her Majesty's officers look like a batch of clumsy, fumbling fools. Those Cavaliers are fast making Britain the laughingstock of the entire world. Why wasn't something done to stop them?
Attempts have been made, sir. But they're as slippery as eels, sir.
In the meantime, I have to bear with the grousing of the War Office and Lord Roberts breathing down the back of my neck. This bungling's gone on long enough. I intend to assign Colonel Dart and you to wipe out the lot of them.
my turn. I think so.
We intend launching a big offensive in the Free State. But our regiments cannot move whilst those men are free to wreck our communications almost at will. I want you to take something for me to General Graham's headquarters. Meanwhile, you better start thinking how you can get past them.
Good morning, Mr. Brown.
Good morning.
Morning.
Could I be of assistance?
I'd like to order a wreath.
A wreath?
A wreath of cherry blossoms.
Cherry blossoms. In January, Mr.
Bowden. Christopher Bowden.
Oh. Well, we'd better discuss this. Will you follow me? Welkom, meneer Botha. Het is voor mij een eer om die leer van die cavaliers persoonlijk te ontmoeten.
Dank u.
Wel, maak je maar thuis.
Het lijkt of u alles van mij al weet.
Dat is mijn taak om zekere dingen te weten, meneer Botha. Oom Paul heeft u zeker laat weten dat ik bij die geheime dienst is.
Ook dat u aan die Britse geheime dienst behoort?
Ja, niet te min een onfeilbare manier om inlichting te krijgen, meneer Botha. Maar nu had onze heel onbekende persoon nodig om die plannen in verband met die Groot-Britse offensief te krijgen. Plannen wat wel die hele verloop van de oorlog kan beïnvloeden.
En dus waarom ik hier is?
Ja, precies. Ik was net bekommerd dat je niet betijds kan komen, nee. Ons wel goed moet spelen. Nou kijk, die hoofd van die Britse generale staf, generaal Sir Godfrey Grey, heeft zijn hoofdkwartier bij die kasteel. Hij is eigenlijk die brein achter die hele plan.
Jullie opdracht is voor een deskundige. Ik is maar een gewone soldaat.
Net een ogenblik, alsjeblieft, meneer Botha. Het is een uitnodiging naar die militaire dans, morgenavond bij die kasteel. Een Britse officier zou jou vergezel. En die generaalse dochter zal ook daar wees. Maak niet zeker dat hij die oude kerel ook ontmoet wordt.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes? Excuse me. Excuse me, gentlemen. I have an important dispatch to attend to.
Good evening.
Your dispatch, sir.
Thank you.
Joan, dear, I'm not feeling very well. I think I've left my smelling salts in the general's office. Would you get them for me, please, dear?
Certainly.
Oh,
boy. How are you?
Fine, thank you.
If you gentlemen would excuse me.
Certainly. Yes, of course. Wonderful show tonight, isn't it?
Yes,
very
good.
I do enjoy the orchestra.
The general's room.
Yes,
well,
sir.
Look for him, you fools.
Hey!
All right, go on. Get after him. After him.
Quick, come along. Thank you.
Pleasure. What's going on?
There was a man in the room. He suddenly grabbed me and pushed me in the cupboard. I was there quite a while. Thank you very much. So that's what he was after.
Yes.
Robbie, you're hurt.
What exactly have you been up to?
This is what he was after.
What the hell are you doing in here?
I heard a noise from the passage and found her locked up in the cupboard there. I don't think she's been harmed.
Excuse me. Excuse me, please. Right, you get these people back to the ballroom.
Please, go back to the ballroom, please.
All right, gentlemen, you take these ladies downstairs. You stay here. Joan!
I'm all right, Father. There was a man in the room. He suddenly grabbed me and pushed me in the cupboard. It was too dark. I couldn't see anything. This gentleman rescued me.
And who are you, sir?
Bowden. Christopher Bowden. I'm from Port Elizabeth. I found this.
My safe! It's been burgled! This is what he wanted, sir. Whoever it was knocked me down.
I see. Nothing seems to have been taken. Probably didn't have enough time.
I'll check on the ground, sir.
Yes, do that. Well, thank you very much indeed, Mr. Bowden, for coming to the assistance of my daughter. The officer will escort you downstairs. I'll be with you later.
You said you're from Port Elizabeth.
Yes, I live there.
I'm leaving for Port Elizabeth soon as a field nurse. Of course, I don't know yet to which unit I'll be posted.
I have a very good knowledge of the country around Port Elizabeth, and I'm sure that I could be of assistance in putting an end to a beau commando known as the Cavaliers, who've been causing quite a bit of trouble in that area. I don't know if you've heard of them.
Who hasn't? They've become such a menace lately that soon we'll have the entire British Army out cavalier hunting.
Why do you think they're so successful?
They're a company of selected men, Captain, who ride magnificent horses. And they're led by a man with a very good eye for an opening.
Yes, well, there's nothing wrong with his eye.
Do you agree with the generally accepted theory that they move from camp to camp?
No, after each attack, I believe they return to a set base and remain there.
A base? Up in the mountains?
Yes, I know of three such places. We could send troops out to their ambush at each entrance, and when they return, well...
With your permission, sir.
Oh, of course, yes, of course. Yes, you've given me quite a lot to think about, Mr. Bowden. I shall contact you tomorrow morning.
Mr. Bowden to see you, sir.
Ah, good morning,
good morning, sir.
Take a seat. I have decided to accept your offer, Bowden. I shall attach you to intelligence, but you will remain a civilian so that you can mix on equal footing with men of higher rank.
Thank you. That's very kind of you, sir. When do I leave?
I want you to leave today. Captain Rogers will give you full particulars. Oh, there is just one more thing, Bowden. It is vitally important that Captain Rogers should immediately contact General Graham of the Eastern Cape High Command.
I see, sir.
You realize that you will be passing pretty close to the Cavaliers?
Yes, sir.
You and Captain Rogers will report then to Colonel Dart, and you will remain under his command. I expect to see the end of the Cavaliers within 1 month.
I'm looking forward to working with your men, sir. I'll do my best to see that the job is well done. Mr. Brown, is he in?
No, sir. He didn't come in this morning. You can see him this afternoon.
But I'm about to leave Cape Town. There's my coach outside waiting for me.
Then why don't you leave Cape Town, Mr. Brown?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, good luck, my darling. Give my love to your uncle.
Mr. Bowden.
Morning.
Au revoir.
Good morning, sir.
Ah, good morning, Mr. Bowden. I forgot to tell you, my daughter and her aunt are accompanying your group. She's visiting her uncle, that's General Graham, before she joins her unit.
Delighted to have you with us, Miss Graham.
Thank you.
I picked this up as requested, sir.
Ah, yes. Well, my dear, a little keepsake.
No, let me do that.
Do you like it?
Help you, sir?
How I wish I could have been here under different circumstances. Why must there always be wars?
People will always find reasons to kill each other. This time it's gold.
You mean the gold of the Witwatersrand round? Do you really think so?
Well, it may be one of the reasons.
President Kruger simply forced England to protect her investment.
I'm not a politician, Miss Gray.
I'll honestly admit that before this, England has had better cause to declare war on the country. There's so many things that neither you nor I know, Mr. Barton.
Would you mind if I ask you a personal question?
It all depends.
You'll find that we people here are very informal. Would you mind if I call you Joan?
After so brief an acquaintance, I'll have to think about it. If you'll excuse me now, I'll see you later.
Ek het gedink jy sal my miskien weer nodig kry. Die planne van die offensief wat kaptein Rogers by hom dra sal in code wees. Wanneer jy het kry, bring dit maar dadelijk. Jy sal alles van hom degelijk moet onderzoek. Geliefkoosde plekke is een revolver, een leerpatroondoppie of die holhak van een schoen.
Goed, ek sal my best probeer.
Ja, dan kry jy my vanavond maar weer hier.
Sorry, old boy. You're all right.
No, I'm done. I was just about to go out.
And go back to the paper, actually. Left it behind somewhere. There we are.
I'm ready. Shall we go?
Yes, after you.
Would you please pass me the salt, Chris? The people here aren't as formal as we are in England.
Yes, we are a friendly people.
Well, just so long as you don't start calling me Ronald, old boy. And that's Joan's privilege. I see the Cavaliers have made the news again. They've disrupted the telephone, road and rail communications in the Eastern Cape. It's a bad show.
Mr. Bowden assures me that he'll get us through safely.
He does he?
If we travel in a large convoy, it could be dangerous. They'd never miss the opportunity of attacking us.
You're quite sure?
The Cavaliers only attack to sabotage, not to kill. If we travel in a small group...
Small groups very often mean greater responsibility, oh boy.
I don't think they'll pay much attention to a young lady like Joan.
I take it you mean Miss Gray.
Yes, Miss Gray.
Miss Gray, who's on a visit to her uncle, accompanied by, say, only a few soldiers.
I don't know. I'll have to get permission from regional headquarters, of course.
Well, as far as I'm concerned, I'd be much happier with a lot of soldiers. I think it's a splendid idea. Oh, Joan.
You're getting to like this Bowden chap quite a lot, aren't you?
It sounds like jealousy talking.
I'm sorry. I'm a bit on edge. We've known each other many years, and yet we've never really... Oh, you know, I'm away the whole time. I hardly ever see you.
From now on, we'll be seeing much more of each other.
How much will you be seeing of him?
Ronnie, this isn't like you at all.
No, tell me, please.
Well, I must admit that I find him fascinating. And I do like him. But you don't have to worry.
Good.
Ek het oral gekyk. Ek het deur alles gesoek wat hy besit, selfs die somme van sy klere. Ek sê jou, daar's niks.
Hy dra dit seker altyd by hom.
Nou sien ek nie ons het hier op die skip gaan wegkry nie. Jy sal moet saamkom.
Maar ek kan nie sommer so met julle saamry nie.
Een van my manne sal jou in Port Elizabeth ontmoet.
Dan ek seker geen teëse nie. Maar ek moet jou waarsku. Ek kan nie goed perdry nie. Jy weet ek kon gerust daar in sy plek sagter gemaak het. Ek voel ek sal nooit weer in my lewe kan sit nie.
Jy kan toch nie die hele pad loop nie.
Wat gaan ons weer so 'n bietjie rus?
Ja, ons sal moet, tot hulle besluit om verder te beweeg.
Maar, is ons dan so naby?
When do you think we'll catch up with the convoy?
One more day. We should reach them by tomorrow evening.
I'm afraid I'm falling in love with the country, Chris. I want to thank you for making this trip so pleasant for me. The 2 days have passed so quickly. You seem to know every stream, every animal, exactly where to go and what to do. It somehow made one feel so carefree and happy. But I've also noticed that something has been troubling me.
Yes?
Especially today. This afternoon. You've become so reserved suddenly.
There is something, but I can't tell you now. You'll know quite soon, and I only hope you'll understand.
Are you married, Chris?
No.
I hope you don't mind my asking. I was just wondering if I did something to hurt you.
No, it's not that at all. I'll always treasure your friendship and your kindness.
You make it sound as though it was something of the past.
Let's go. They're waiting for us.
What's wrong?
I thought I saw two men following us, sir.
Men are following us, one dressed in black.
I can't see them now.
Amongst those trees, sir.
Maybe we can catch one of these cavaliers alive.
There might be more of them. And they're the best shots in the Boer army. I don't think we should try anything now. They know all about us.
What happened to your necklace?
I don't know.
Come on, let's go and look for it.
What's the matter?
Joan lost the necklace down at the river.
Young man, I'm quite aware of Joan's carelessness, but what were you looking at?
There were two men following us.
What?
One was dressed in black.
The cavaliers?
Now, don't get upset. We saw only one, and I don't think he'll attack us.
I stood here, patting him.
Who, the horse?
Oh, Ronnie.
Sorry, that wasn't very fair, was it? I wonder where it is. The chain's broken. Let me fix it for you. Joan, will you forgive me now?
Only if you promise to behave yourself.
I promise.
Will we be able to stay overnight?
Yes, I think so. I was just wondering.
Wondering?
Does your father usually give you a going-away present?
I must admit it came as a surprise to me. I've never known father to be sentimental. But after all, his only daughter is going to war.
Afternoon. Afternoon, ma'am.
Wat sê die kakie?
Nee, ek dink hy groet maar net.
Where's the young girl who can interpret? Can talk for us, you know, the young girl who was here last time.
Can I help?
Yes, please.
Middag, tante.
Middag.
Middag, oom.
Middag, neefie.
Middag.
Die kaptein wil weet waar die jong meisie is.
Sy saam met die kavaliers.
Die kavaliers?
Wat so snaaks daaraan? Her moeder het ook vir die boere geveg.
What's this about the cavaliers? They're in the vicinity.
Lovely evening, isn't it?
Yes, isn't it? Pity there's a war.
What do you know of warfare?
Not much, I'm afraid.
Well, let me tell you something. There's something similar between war and this thing they call love. There's no in-between, one either wins or loses. Do you understand?
Yes, I do.
Good. Let's drink to that, shall we? To the winner?
To the loser?
Surely choose the strangest times and places. You're going to say something? Is that all? Haven't you got anything to say?
I already said it. Whatever happens, please try and understand.
To take no action.
Yes, sir.
That's an order.
Yes, sir.
Oh, there's a cavalier down there. What does he want?
You, I should imagine, madam. Resistance. We're accompanying the young lady to our uncle, General Graham, at the front. Right, Captain, ask your men to hand over their rifles. You heard him. Hand over your rifles!
Chris, we're in trouble. What did you do?
Joan, I,
Welcome, Chris.
Who hunted? Well, Captain.
But I don't understand.
I'm Falconet Butta of the South African Republic. I'm commander of the Cavaliers. My country needs important information, and I've been ordered to get it. It ought to be clear to you, Captain. I led you to this house in the hope that I would get the operation orders which you're carrying for General Graham.
Operation orders? I'm afraid I don't know what you mean.
That I cannot accept. If you take that attitude, I'll be compelled to have you searched.
There's no other attitude I can take. I've no orders for General Graham.
Harry, laat die kaptein in die huis uittrek en bring sy klere na die skuur toe.
Your sword, please, Captain. Maar goed, Chris, hier is alles.
Dank je. Maar ik heb een mooi onderzoek.
Wacht, wacht, wacht. Mooi, sir.
Gerry, snij al die somme los en die hoed en geef het terug.
Ik maak zo.
Ik zal eerst hiervan een afschrift moeten maken.
Ons moet gauw maken, daar is een groot Engelse kolom aan die kom.
Is hulle nabij?
Man, dat is moeilijk om te zeggen. Maar ik zie hoe sê, as hulle eerst ons spoor gekregen, dan is daar moeilijkheid.
Hoe lang nog?
Ik doe mijn best.
Chris, die kakies ontzingen ons nu.
Nee, nog meer.
Nog een keer snij.
At last.
Hier zijn.
Is die verkenners al terug? Waar is die kakies nou?
Hulle is hier achter die randjes, maar hulle kom baie vinnig nader.
Hou die mannen gereed. Geer het vir hom, maar moenie een woord sê.
Nou maar goed. Please, you ladies must go inside now.
Nonsense. What on earth are you people up to now?
It's not us that's up to anything. Your people are coming and they might be shooting.
The British?
Sy sal hele rukkie by ons. Ek wou jou gevra het, Chris. Gerry het gesê sy kan by ons bly tot jy terugkom.
Sorg net dat die Engels haar nie sien nie.
Dankie, Chris.
Captain, I thought that you had the information on your person. But it appears that I've made a mistake. I must ask you and Joan to pardon me for the role that I was forced to play. You're a soldier, you'll understand. But I doubt whether Joan ever will. In time of war, a soldier can have no personal feelings. He must think only of the needs of his country. We're surrounded, and we'll have to shoot our way out. I trust that we'll meet again one day under happier circumstances. Captain, the farmer and his wife had nothing to do with whatever happened here today.
The men are ready now, sir.
If only we can get near enough.
Moenie jou bekommer nie, ek gaan hulle koppe plat hou.
Nee, wacht, Chris, jy kom nou net hier, laat ek nou maar gaan.
Dis tyd dat ek nou weer iets gaan doen.
Maar ik moet Chris helpen. Kom.
Wat doe jij?
your men ready to follow them immediately.
Sir.
Colonel Darter. Excuse me, sir. It's of the utmost importance that I reach General Graham as soon as possible. I request permission to be escorted to headquarters immediately, sir.
Are you trying to tell me that we should not follow them, Captain? Do you realize they wiped out an entire convoy last night, just a little way from here? Our railway line is a total wreck. This has been going on for some time, and headquarters is holding me responsible.
I know, sir. But I'm carrying operational orders, sir, that must not fall into the wrong hands. I can't take any further chances, sir.
Blast your operational orders.
Ek hoor jy het Chris se lewe gered.
O nee, Louise, jou geweer het.
Jy's te beskeie.
Mondelijk.
Hoe lyk hy? Ons het al 'n paar skote met hom geskiet ook. Daan Groblaar was mos in die staatsartillerie gewees.
Mooi so, ons het so groot geraas nodig.
Dat sal daarom nou bietjie vinniger gaan. Ek het die kode.
Hoe lyk het? Is dat daarom die moeite waard?
Meer is wat jy ooit kan besef. Hier jou papiertje gaat die hele keer per nieuwe oorlog wees. Hulle het groot plannen.
As het zo'n belangrijke boodschap die is, wie gaan jy stuur, Chris?
Ja, ek wil jou gevraagd. Daar mag jy fout kom nie. Generaal de Wet moet hier die inlichting kry.
Ek voel geëerd. Ek sal my best probeer.
Gelukkig lyk ek net soos 'n kakkie.
Ek hoop jy voel nie soos jy nie.
Nee, nog nooit nie. Tot ziens.
Tot ziens, Gerry.
Came along this valley, sir, on the road to the field hospital. And the machine guns were hidden inside the wagons. But they must have spotted that there was something wrong. They fired from 400 yards, never came any closer. Our losses were very heavy, sir.
And you, Major?
Well, they very nearly fell into the trap, sir. I took the column around to get in from behind. We actually caught them unawares, sir, but they got away. They have very fast horses.
Very well, gentlemen. That will be all. Oh, Colonel Dodd. I've had another note from General Gray. It's serious, and also your last chance, Colonel. He wants results, even if he can only catch one of them alive. It's obvious to me they have a new hideout, so we'd better set a new trap for them. It's bound to work sooner or later.
Yes, sir.
Hoe lang gaan ons nog hier in die berge sit en wag?
Totdat het donker is.
Dink jy Daad gaan weer iets probeer? Daarvan kan jy seker wees. Die Engelse begin ons daarom nou hier vasdruk. Ons moet hier bly tot ons iets van Gerry hoor.
Lyk my as van die nat word.
Nee, man. De Haribolken heeft meer geraas als water en hulle.
Chris, denk je niet ons moet...
Genuchtig. Beesten.
Zal weer rijden van het trom.
Het Engelse veldhospitaal is laar af van die vallei.
Jij is recht. Ons kan hem niet keer nie, maar ons kan proberen wegkeer. Louise, jij blijft hier. Dan blijf bij die kanon. Echt?
Chris.
Kan ik hem helpen?
Alsjeblieft, Chris.
Ja, kom maar, Sam. Ik zie je geweer nodig, hè.
Ik versta.
Dank je.
Right, come on, you better get him along. Now, not that way. Come on, you two, come on, all of them.
Thank you.
vuur!
Zijn allemaal hier?
Sarah zal niet wees niet, Chris. Zijn paard het geval. Hij heeft net voor mij gereden en hij was lelijk.
Dat is bevreesd.
Ja.
See you again. There's so much I want to say to you.
I've missed you too.
We're old friends.
We are very grateful to you and your men for what you've done.
Conquerors, daar brengen we nou voor Sarah.
Excuse me.
I'd like to have the honor of burying him.
Before we can consider it, I must tell you that there's a company of about 300 cavalry approaching.
Thanks for telling me. But I'll ride out and talk to their commanding officer. I don't think you'll have anything to worry about. Meanwhile, may I make preparations for the funeral?
Yes, thank you. Maar aan, Ben. Ik geloof niet ons hoef ons meer te bekommer nie.
Well, we meet again, old boy.
Hello, Major.
Seems we owe you a great deal.
I'm sure you would have done the same.
Perhaps not as smart as you did, though. Thank you very much indeed.
Almachtige hemelse Vader, waar ons hier voor u staan met smart in die hart, aanbid ons u als beschikker over ons lot. U het een uit ons midden weggeneem en ons bid u nou om kracht en troos en sterkte voor die strijd wat voorlê. Amen.
May God rest his soul.
Chan! Slow up! Standing, look, present, fire, slope, arms, present, arms.
Excuse me. Look.
In the circumstances, I feel I should tell you we've been ordered to wipe out the Cavaliers at all costs. Colonel Dart, my commanding officer, feels it a personal insult that he hasn't been able to catch you yet. Now, I shan't follow you, but I suggest you keep a sharp lookout for him.
Thank you.
Good.
Chris, how can you people expect to win?
Well, President Kruger is going overseas to get help. He can only succeed if our armies are still in the field.
Do you think you'll get any help?
Name the country that will benefit by being our friend, and we'll know the answer.
But in the meantime, two civilized people must destroy each other.
Precisely. And in the meantime, we soldiers must do our duty. Mine is to take my men back to the hills. Now. Goodbye, Joan. Keep well.
Look after yourself.
Goodbye, Major.
Good luck, old boy.
Goed julle manne opklim.
Maar hierdie plek wemel van die kamp.
This one's still alive, sir.
Oh, God. Look, you better get him to hospital immediately. He's bleeding profusely.
Yes, sir.
Well, Major, you've missed all the fun. We've got one alive at last. Well, Major, don't you...
Congratulations, sir.
Well, I...
I think he got it in the left shoulder.
Very bad.
Where's the prisoner?
In the last tent on the right, sir.
Troop, halt!
Quite a prize, then, Major. The Colonel wanted one alive, didn't he?
Yes, we must notify him immediately.
Oh, Ronnie, you can't.
It's our duty, Joan. Lieutenant. I'd advise you to keep your men on the alert tonight. If the Cavaliers find this man's alive, they'll come and get him.
Is he that important, sir?
Oh, yes. He's Fulco on a boat at their leader.
My mother always told me, angels wore white.
How are you feeling?
Much better. Thank you. My men. How many dead?
14, I think.
What troubles me is that wound. It's bad. He must be kept very quiet. Must there be so many men around?
He's a valuable prisoner, Doctor. This news is going to spread like wildfire throughout the country. His men will certainly know by tomorrow.
What do you think will happen to him, sir?
He's a spy, isn't he?
You're neglecting your patients.
Some of them deserve it.
I object, Your Honor.
Objection overruled.
On what grounds, Your Honor?
I've been looking after the men you put in hospital.
How long will I be here?
10 days.
That should give my men enough time.
Do you really think your men are going to help you escape? Listen, Chris, you and your men have done wonderful things. Things that you can really be proud of. But the English troops here regard your capture as extremely important and won't hesitate to shoot on sight at anything suspicious. And anyway, I won't allow it.
You won't allow it? And what about the firing squad?
I'll speak to my father and General Graham.
And ask them to allow me to grow old gracefully in Ceylon.
Pears, and some grapes,
and
some of those, and some
peaches.
Fine.
Good morning, Colonel. How's the eye this morning?
Blasted mosquitoes, damn irritating. I'm Colonel Dart from the Intelligence Department. Do you deny that you are Field Cornet Botha?
No. Why should I?
Good. Now, there are a few questions I want you to answer. Exactly how many men do you have under your command?
Well, Colonel, let's see now. There's Dan, Piet, Koos, Johan, oh yes, and there's Billy, Gert, Kobus, Niels, Chris. I'm afraid I've run out of fingers, Colonel, and I can't reach my toes.
I warn you, Botham, I won't stand for any impertinence. Colonel, I'm having this prisoner removed to Pretoria.
I'm sorry, sir, but I'm under the orders of the Brigadier only. You'll have to give me his written permission to have this patient removed.
Are you challenging my authority?
Concerning this patient, sir, yes. Now, I must ask you to leave.
You're terribly concerned with the health of the enemy.
I am a doctor, sir.
Enige nuus?
Hy's gewond, maar nie ernstig nie.
Wat is hulle sterkte?
Hulle het die hele regiment gestuur om hom op te pas.
Will you be all right, sir?
Yes, thank you.
As you see, I also had to leave Cape Town, Mr. Bowden.
Ah, yes. The undertaker. I'm sorry to disappoint you, but I'm not quite dead yet.
I've come to give evidence at your court-martial, Field Cornet. We caught Brown, and the dear old soul told us everything. So we had to change our plans for the offensive. Without the plans, your people have practically lost the war.
Did you expose Brown? Get out!
When I'm ready, Buta, you failed. We can also destroy your cavaliers when they return to their hideout. All you have left is the love of the general's daughter.
Get out of here! Get out of here! You get out!
Calm down. You
get out!
What's
happening? Save your energy. He'll do anything now to escape.
You're not looking very well.
I'm terribly tired.
How is he?
I think he's improving.
You know,
I got to like him quite a lot. I shudder when I think of what they're going to do to him.
They're going to shoot him, aren't they?
Yes, they are.
But surely his friends will...
They won't be able to help him. Not this time.
Oh, no, you don't.
I feel fine. I've been resting for 8 days now.
You're not to get up without the doctor's permission. Please get back to bed, or else I'll have to call the guard.
I just wanted to say hello to them.
You're behaving very badly. Chris, I'm so worried. Come back to bed. I caught him trying to walk around a moment ago. I've put him back into bed.
Well, the brigadier's given Dart permission to remove him in 2 days' time. Not well enough yet, but he's out of my hands now. By the way, I hear one of our patrols is missing. The Cavaliers must be up to something.
Miss Gray, Colonel Dart is sending for the prisoner today. I'm leaving now to prepare for his trial in Pretoria.
You and the Colonel are very sure he's going to get there, aren't you?
Unless he gets help.
Are you implying that...
No, no. I meant his men, Miss Gray. Oh. One moment, please. Give him this. I've written it in his own language, Afrikaans. It's to congratulate him if he ever manages to escape. I'm sure you can tear it up in 2 days' time. Goodbye.
How I hate you.
Tell me where I'm likely to find the officer in charge of the prisoner.
Yes, there's Colonel Ross now. I've been expecting you. I'll get the prisoner ready.
Well, that's much appreciated, sir. It's to a special timetable that I'm working. And now, if the young lady would kindly prepare for the journey, as the general has ordered that she also come along. That is, if you are Sister Gray.
Yes, I'm Sister Gray. You say the general has sent for me?
That's right, ma'am.
Better get him ready, sister.
It is Captain O'Reilly reporting, sir, with orders to remove the prisoner to headquarters.
With this escort?
That's right, sir, but you must not be forgetting the cart, sir.
But why such a small escort?
Well, now, I'm not in the general's confidence, sir, but as I understand it, he wants to avoid a fight at any price and risk filling the hospital again before the march begins.
But such a small escort would give the Cavaliers all the inducement to attack.
Possibly, sir, if they thought that their leader was with us. Sir, in the past 4 days, 400 men have been patrolling these areas. The hills are alive with people. The Cavaliers will be expecting a large body to escort their leader. They're not likely to pay so much attention to a small detachment, merely escorting the general's niece.
There's scarcely room for three on that seat.
Oh, nonsense, sir. There's a special place been prepared for you. It is in the box on the cart where no one will be seeing you.
Don't stay away too long, Joan. We need you here.
I'll be back. Goodbye.
Giddy up.
Why such a small escort, Pat? It almost gave the Colonel wrong ideas.
Best I could do, Chris.
There aren't a dozen of our blokes who could pass for Englishmen.
Just what exactly is going on here?
The driver, Joan, is Pat Murphy. The captain in charge of the escort is Michael O'Reilly. They're all members of the Irish Brigade, which joined the Boer forces.
Then they're your men.
I'm sorry we had to drag you into this, miss, but if we hadn't, they'd have probably queried the general's signature.
You're impossible. I just can't wait to see the general's face when he hears about this.
How far are our men, Michael?
Must be about 20 miles, Chris.
We'll never make it.
An instruction from the brigadier to you, placing you under my order. And authorizing you to remove the prisoner to headquarters.
Oh, prisoner?
Yes, the prisoner.
You better read this.
Where did you get this?
It was handed me by a Captain O'Reilly. They can't be very far.
You fool! This is forgery! Do you realize what you've done? You've handed the prisoner back to his own men. Major, get out of those men immediately. And you, Colonel, get your men to saddle their horses.
Sir. Bugler, sound the alarm.
Harry. Ek het die boodskap afgegee.
Daar's nou groot moeilikheid. Hulle het Brown gevang en toe al hulle planne verander.
Ag nee. En wat gaan ons nou maak? Moenie vir my sê ons moet weer reg van voor af begin nie.
Daar's nie meer tyd hoor nie. As ons net lewendig hier kan uitkom, sal ons gelukkig wees. Jong, waar's die pere?
Nee, jy moet jou nie vandag daaroor bekom aan die Chris. Ons het alles gereël. Reg, manne!
Haven't you forgotten about me?
Jy het 5 minute om te groet, Chris.
There's no point in waiting, is there?
Only a few seconds.
I mean for us. After the war, you'll have to go back to England.
I've already made up my mind to stay in your country and wait for you. If you won't be too bitter.
It means until we meet again.
Wonderful. They'll never catch you now.
I'll take you for a ride on it after the war.
Oh, I almost forgot. A dreadful man gave me this. He also thought you wouldn't make it.
Hy was tog aan ons kant. Hier, Gerry, lees.
Dear Falconer, a wreath of cherry blossoms to you. Die nuwe planne vir die Britse offensief is die volgende. Trap, mannen, die generaals wacht vir ons.